And you have probably seen videos from me where, oh, I'm not that impressed with arts, why I don't really care about arts, why I hate arts and all these things. And I stand by those videos. And there will also be people out there saying, well, you fool, we have seen you use Manjiao. Well, Manjiao is not arts. I have videos about it. Even the Manjiao developers themselves say, loud and clearly, Manjiao is not arts. I don't know why I need to repeat myself every time I talk about Manjiao. That out of the way. Why did I come back to arts then? Well, I didn't really come back to arts. I'm running it in a virtual machine. I want to mess with arts again because I am going to do something I do kind of once or twice a year. I need to be better at coding. I start to code, and then after a month, I don't touch coding for 6 months. Then I code for a month and I don't touch it for 6 months. I need to be more consistent with it. I have had a goal of mine to make convenient and easy to use scripts for Arch and Manjiao. Because like I said, even though Manjiao is not 100% compatible with Arch, they are utilizing a lot of the same technologies, the Pac-Man and so on and so on. So a lot of things you can translate over to Manjiao from Arch Linux, just like a lot of things you can translate from Debian to Ubuntu, even though Ubuntu is not 100% pure Debian, it's a Debian respin. It's based on Debian. So there are a lot of things you can do the same, and there's a lot of things that's not the same. So I thought it would be a good idea to do Arch Manjiao scripts, because there's a lot of room for improvement in the arts communities and the Manjiao communities to give people more convenient ways of doing their thing. Like one of my crazy goals is to automate the arts wiki. So if you want to do something within the arts wiki, I will make a script for it. Probably never going to happen, but it's one of my pipe dreams. So if you want to replace Paul's audio with pipe wire, I would just make a script that basically doing what the Arch Wiki is telling you to do. So you, instead of you having to type everything else, you just go by 1, 2, 3, you know, make a point menu that you can follow. Why? Just because I want to get better at coding. But I need a distribution where I can test the art side of those scripts. So EndeavourOS. So why EndeavourOS? Why EndeavourOS? Well, I like the community way better than the vanilla Arch community. They are one of the few Arch Linux distributions out there that are actively doing things to make Arch better for the community. They are helping people way better than the Arch community. They are less toxic than the Arch community. They are just, in general, they have a way better community than almost any other Arch Linux distribution out there or Arch Linux derivative out there. And I like the space theme. I'm a bit of a space nerd. So I like this whole, you know, space theme that they're going. It makes me think a little bit of Star Trek. Like, it gives me a little bit of a Star Trek feeling. So yeah, I like it. I'm a little bit biased of the, you know, the way it's set up, the theme of it. But mostly it's because of the community. So I decided to install EndeavourOS. Why not? I could have gone with Salient OS, Easy Arch, or Easy Arch, or what the fuck you will call it. But I think Esnik's ego is way too big as it is, so I decided against that right out of the bat. If I'm going to run Arch, I kind of want a distribution with a really, really great community behind it. Because if I get problems with my script, I could go and ask that community for help. You're never too old or too good to ask for help. I had a teacher one time when I was a mechanic. He told me, Kent, you don't need to know everything, but what you do need to know is where to find the information that you need. And he said, that's what a good mechanic is. They don't know everything. They know how to acquire the information. And I kind of believe that. You don't need to know everything, because I read every fucking handbook about cars too, and memorized them from page one to the last page. And of course I couldn't do that. But I thought that as a mechanic, you have to know every fucking thing about cars. No. You just need to know who to ask, where to seek that help. And then it comes down to the support structure. And the support structure for EndeavourOS is amazing. I know how to get help with Arch Linux. But why not associate myself with a community that value its users and don't mind stupid questions, don't mind helping people, don't mind acknowledging when things go shit up, you know, when things break. So yeah, it's like it's a no-brainer for me. I've been a massive fan of EndeavourOS since it came out, the first release. I installed their first release when it came out. I have been using EndeavourOS since the first release. I've taken breaks here and there, but every time I go back to Arch, I may install Salient OS or Easy Arch or some other Arch Linux respin, you know, just to try it out. But I always end up on EndeavourOS. It just seems to be the best built default Arch installation as I like it. It fits my needs the best. Plus, I like the theming, the community, and all, you know, all of these extra benefits with it. So yeah, I'm back on Arch. Not on Metal, not full time. I just needed a test VM basically for when I'm going to make the scripts. And here's the kicker. When I am coding those Manjaro Arch scripts, I'm doing it under Manjaro because it's not changing as rapidly as Arch Linux is, meaning I don't have to update as fast or as often. And yeah, I still have the same opinions about Arch Linux. I will not go to install Arch Linux on bare metal. I'm tired of being a system administrator for my host OS. I really am. Some people love it. I just don't. I've tried too many times, come home from work really fucking tired, and then doing an update or do something with Arch, and I have to spend 15 minutes just to fucking watch Pornhub. I don't want to do that anymore. I'm getting too fucking old for that. When I come home and I want to see a fucking big titty ladies, I just want to watch big titty ladies. I don't want to sit and do this fucking administrative task to watch big titty ladies, okay? I don't know what more to say. I think I've been rambling along way too much. Maybe now I should go and watch big titty ladies. I don't know. See y'all later. Bye-bye.